Kisumu, ubiro karumbu, kenda mo gibiro maru, kenda mo gitopo maru, kenda mo gutundo maru. Unyiso hera, unyiso ikendo mabera yenya yo Kisumu, ubiro gikwe, kendo ubiro gichama mar MDG. Wabiro kae kawuono, mondo wanyiso Kisumu, ni chama mar MDG en chama margi. Ni chama mar MDG en chama mar Kenya mangima. Ni chama mar MDG en chama mosewuok nitie oganda mondo gano dhi mbele mondo wane ni gik ma chunywa nita gombo e telo mar pinyni otundo. Hata wakato ni ya hata kwa mutulie wale wako nyuma hapo tutulie kidogo nitaongea kwa muda kidogo lakini ningependa msikize sawa sawa. Tumezona vizuri? Ameja kwa dunia joturwa. Ni igimunyiso kawono omi ukabaya beti kacha amoro sidan. Piyo mabotu kubo. Kech unyiso kido marhera. Kech unyiso kido marchir. Chir ni gimora mora ma ikete chunyi nyalore. Chir ni kese yomok nyakati. Yomok mhoni mwalo, yomok seme. Kaki dilo kaya kawono yomok wesi is. Isento ginyando kwa ingiru hizilo mogingano lakini yu kigeno nikeja kama ki ae yu kama nye walgie give leave ni chie mwere pini ikenya kai give ni give jomili yao kuto kama ano yu believe nubende ikenya kai kwa demu ae unye loti yu gite kuu mune loka kajyo dake pini kuto kama ano kamu ae ubilo kaya kugeno ni kutiyo matek ni chube chie mwere natelo wabere pini ni mwere musene eno Wedemo aye yuto ubiro kaya kugeno nikawa tiyo mabere gitimo mare MDG tukena kaya yoro kaya unye tino itinye mabere magedo waro itino so mabere tukusure magedo yeye mane gigo kaya ukwe kawono kumu aye nyasayo kwa dina uduto kumbiro maru maru yu madunga enjo turwa eni waromo ekinde malicha hinya waromo ekinde mapinyo kagre pin ogoyamo pin ogo ubira uchiel nikeche yo pin wacho niya nito wadhi kanyi kichie okinyi sikuli mizo chomi kichie okinyi koso vili no chomi kichie okinyi na matuwa ya hospital kama hile pesa kata yatmi ya hospital onge waromu sama pinyi vijo matek tosa mwantie sani higini pra uchiel gachiel bank independence 20 years bank independence ukono venuwa kwa siyasa kendo wane gore kinde cha ndalo maja nungi gore ni pin ndalo maja nungi gore ni pin ndalo maja masina mbo nungi gore ni pin ndalo makara nangale gore ni pin kia kwa sikuja ndalo maja chungu nungi gore ni pin negi manju mayoso kimuka dikende adikende negi ngani kaki nyalogolo kimilongo ni vier kaki nyalogolo kimilongo ni four kaki nyalogolo kimilongo ni two opili yuna mabe lakini sani kwenye ochiel kose kalo podu wa tuu wazire mwono kano wazire kinde kaa nitoi vye school somo golo ujinga utije onge omeo kenya mwante sani okeani kenya wanya longada ya lo wacho nene kenya ya kujibunia let me say that in English that we meet at a time when the country is at crossroads. We meet at a time as the country is wondering whether it was worth it for our forefathers to fight the wars they fought. Achengo Neko, Jena Mungo Gingo Dinga, Maside Muliro, Ngala Gule Wapwani, Jomo Kenyatta. They fought so hard so that you may get our independence. They fought so hard so that Kenya could rule itself. And when we got independent in 1963, the rallying call for the country was to deal with the disease, deal with poverty, and deal with illiteracy. 20 years later, the country is sick. 20 years later, we are poorer than we were at that time. 20 years later, our children go to school, but have no jobs to go to after school. But 20 years later, we are still struggling with the problems that our forefathers got here to deal with. And that's why as MDG, when we meet today, we must assess as a country? Where are we? What have we done right? What have we done wrong? What can we change? What can we abandon in this country today? People don't know whether tomorrow they will wake up to a better country. Yet in 2002, Kenyans were judged as the most hopeful nation in the world. When Kibaki took power, that hope has dissipated. That hope has gone, replaced with despair, replaced by frustration, replaced by poverty, replaced by just a threat of survival. Let us not lose hope. Let's not lose hope. Because all of you who are here today, those of you who have come to witness this convention today, I believe that you singularly, you individually, you as a group, you as a polling station, you as a sub-location, you as a ward, you as a constituency, can work and change this country for the better. And I believe in you, because I've listened to you, I've heard what you've said, and I've seen the hope, the energy and the power in your voices. I know that you, the people of Kisumu, can change this country for the better. Umeangeyo kamantini ni okabiro nono okawoto nono eno kogimo miyo kachiko yita kabinjo kabinjo pachu kano kakaumiel kanelo kakasa omrobele uwoyo kae tangeyo ni itu kae uyach yach maru chenji mwondu wala mwono pinyo betko angeyo lugo mwono kabisa ni kenya kae vichumo bede pin mideo mwono kabisa. We are still ruled by tribalism. Ukabila imeingia nchi yetu hii kama kansa kubwa sana. Ukabila imeingia nchi yetu hii kama ugonjwa ya ukimu inaua sisi wote. Ukabila lazima iishe Kenya hii. Kama MDG tunaamini kwamba ili nchi iende mbele lazima tujione kama wa Kenya. Lazima tujione kama watu kutoka hapa. There's no republic of Mount Kenya. There's no republic of Rift Valley. There's no republic of Nyanza. There's no republic of West Africa. There's a republic of Kenya. Go to Kamano. And so we must work together as MDG members and as Kenya to build one united, prosperous country called the Republic of Kenya. So I want to warn anybody who thinks that it can divide this country along tribal lines, that, oh, this is called Mount Kenya. Oh, this is kama Rift Valley, kama Kalenjin. Oh, this is kama watu wa wapi. We don't want that to be talk. We don't want that because if this country belongs to two people only. This country belongs to all of us, and as MDG we have promised we're going to go around all this country to preach the message of peace, the message of oneness, the message of one United Republic of Kenya. Kukwanya bedo Uganda, mangamwe ito telo, tongyuma na kapong ae. And I'm not afraid to say, in Kenyatta 1, Kikuyu ruled as if the country belonged to them. When Moi took over power for 24 years, you could not imagine that any other tribe exists in this country. Kibaki tried to change this country for the better. But if you come back to it, during Uhuru Kibaki's first term, you would not imagine. Ata leo hii bino Kenya kwanza. Lakini akata. The issue of colonizing this country must stop. The issue of colonizing this country must stop. We must always try to build one year economic country called Kenya. Atuwezi kukawa kwamba, kama ukukiongozini, unachukua watu kabila yako ndio wanaongoza kila mtu. Look at the cabinet today. Our cabinet has 22 members. Out of the 22 members of the cabinet, 12, 12. Who in a tattoo are from only two regions. Yet you have 41 tribes. You cannot build a country like that. And us as MDG, we are promising you that when you take over power in this country, we will appoint ministers in location. Kwamba tutaanza kama mimi rais natoka Nyanza, tutachukua mtu mmoja kutoka Nyanza, vichukua kutoka every other region. One minister from Nyanza, one from Western, one from Kisi, one from Masailand, one from Kikuyu, one from Kalenjin, yo mpaka waisha wote. Then inaisha hivi pop, tutachukua wale watapata ministry, we'll get two PSS from one minister, from our government. So that every community feels part of this government in this country. We cannot have a second way. Because we must do this deliberately. You are not okay to ministers. What quite a jail per community. Come on, May 22, to go in much, come on, come on, progress, drug out, kill a going to belong in pieces are here. So that everybody born in this country, however small like the Jams, however small like the Tugans, however small like the Mijikenda, every Kenyan must feel as part of this country. Number two, very important again, is that as a country, na tukifanya campaign, unasikia, wanaongea wanasema, Kenya hii itakuwa kama Singapore, Kenya hii itakuwa kama South Korea, Kenya hii itakuwa kama Malaysia, Kenya hii itakuwa kama UK. Sikatai. But you must check, what did the UK do right? What did Singapore do better than us? Because it is said that in 1980, when this country was already 17 years old, the Singaporeans, the Malaysians came to Kenya and picked our economic policies. They went there and implemented them. Now, as we speak today, we only talk about Singapore as if it's something in the air. I'll tell you today that Singapore did only one thing right. Singapore ensured that when they won independence in 1965, they sent their best minds to go to colleges abroad. When they went to Harvard, when they went to Oxford, Cambridge, or no, everywhere they could send them. And then they brought them back. In Singapore, in Malaysia, government is run by the best schooled. Government is run by the most competent people. Government is run by people who understand what they are doing in government. Government is run by people who have gone to school and know their mandate. So don't tell us about Singapore and South Korea if your government is made up of people who are incompetent. You will not make it. Mimi nataka mfunge macho kwenye huko leo. Alafu, above close your eyes and figure what our government looks like today. Fikiria waziri wa agriculture ni nani? Waziri wa elimu ni nani? Waziri wa trade ni nani? Waziri, unaweka waziri wa agriculture cannot coordinate between a water pipe and a water tank. Any, we are dealing with someone who cannot, the country cannot move, if you're going to a point where who cannot understand their dockets. And this I get because I heard the president say this himself early this year. Nilisikia rais akisema kwamba some of his cabinet ministers are incompetent. I want to challenge the president today that if you truly believe that some of your cabinet ministers are incompetent, sack them, put in the right people on the government with you. That's what you need to do. If some of your peers are incompetent, sack them, give the jobs to Kenyans who are deserving and who are competent enough to run those ministries. And as MPG, we believe that our best resource, our biggest resource, our most important resource, as MPG believe, is what we call the human resource, our minds, our brains. That's the best we have as a country. And so I want to say this in Kisumu, that for us as a country to run well, we must appoint civil servants who will serve the government, not the government to serve them. You cannot want the government to get rich, to steal from us, instead of serving Kenyans the way they're supposed to be served. We will appoint a competent, transparent, ethical government when you get to power as MDG. Number three, very important, as a country, corruption now seeps within our psyche like water, like air. Corruption has become a lifestyle. Corruption has become the only thing that most people don't do in this country. Barabara ambayo itakana jengwe na milioni 200, na jengwe na milioni 500. Corruption has gone even into schools. Peter has wanafunzi mwalimu anakuja shule anafunza 40 minutes anarudi kwa duka yake akae shule. You mean the high schools where teachers for you to get a little go to high school, lakini mtoe pesa ndio pale baraya kijana aende shule. Tumefika mahali kwamba kama inchi atuaminiani. If you are going to run a country where everyone benefits from the proceeds of our taxes, if you're going to run a country where everyone benefits from the proceeds of our sweat, we must deal with corruption perpendicularly. We must deal with corruption methodically. We must deal with corruption strategically, so that as a country, the resources that we get, the small ones we get, goes where they're supposed to go. Number 4. Ya muhimu sana. Yukusuma untie. Yukusuma untie. Abiru uwe kodu kawono. Nyaka uwe kodu. Number 4. I'm very important. Maun kaini. Maka undelegates magi MD jini. Kurudu li yero. Kata kia ane ukaye kawugo yeni ngato mwe yeri imaya ukubee molo ngani. Kuto kamano. Ana hero lwenye lwenye mabee na bide momi adake mantie. Ana kama joko leo kwa kubana kama mtie. Kama uwe koko kwa jini flore kama kama. O kaduwa maraki alota neza. Kaduwa kama jini uwa re tuwa iwa eto ngubi wa matindo. Ati kama kama. Kwa pili mbe kwa kama. Kwa kama kwa kama kwa kama. Number 4. Ni ikenya kai. Ikenya kai. There's something going on that has to be addressed. The way we elect our leaders. In Kenya today, elections and politics has become a business investment. Elections and politics in a kuwa biashara. Sasa ya Kenya yukua nini? Biashara. Kwamba mtu anauza shamba lake, akuja yake milioni 5 ili kesha pate milioni 10. Wewe anataka kuwa governor, anatafuta rafiki yake au rafiki yake 10 hivi 15. If you want to be a governor, you look for your 10 friends or 15. You see it somewhere and say wewe leta milioni 10. Wewe leta milioni 10. Wewe leta milioni 15. Nikishinda Kisumu governor, tutakula pamoja. That's what's happening now. But our leadership positions are now, we are not electing servants, we are not electing leaders to serve us. We are electing leaders who are investors. They don't want to serve us, they want to invest and get their money back. We as a country must change the way we elect our leaders. And that's what I have to tell you. Yumanikai kawono. And I know, because I know this party is run transparently and with integrity. Yukisumu. Kumukai ndio wale wa MCS because ukweli chenye ngatangata. Kao yero MCA kama iae ebondemi yo come to a campaign lockdown. Sawa sawa. Kao yero MP kama iae maana wali campaign lockdown. Ndio kama ano. Watu waro ni kikubele ya dokana rumbi kuja 2026. Ili sasa kama chama mara MDG tuwe unia sasa kibili na beach hamia ticket ili sasa kama chama ndio unaonekea kama ndio kama iae. We don't want that in our party. And that's why you want to tell parties in this country that let's try to elect leaders with integrity, leaders with the heart and the will to serve the people of this country. Mugiki, number 5. Ambayo, muhimu sana. Today in Parliament, I sit in the Budget Committee. And I've checked the last 2 years' budgets I've done. And I've been in Bunge for 3 terms now. And I've checked how this country distributes its resources. In the last 11 years, we have built around 6,500 kilometers of low volume steel roads. Out of these 6,000 kilometers of low volume steel roads, utapata kwamba Central Kenya, yuko na 1,800 kilometers ya barabara. Rift Valley, 1,700 kilometers ya barabara. Nyanza, kilomita 250. Western Kenya, kilomita 320. Na inji kwa inji moja, wote tunalipa tax. Katika inji tu, bombo zile zimejengwa na dams. Ukienda Central Kenya, uone zile bombo zimejengwa huko na dams. Na hapa Rift Valley, utapata kwamba they take 60% of the water budget only got two regions in this country, two regions. Ile 40% usafu na gangana sisi wata Turukana, Coast, Western, 40% kwa nangania. Ukijukua, ukingalia the budget for school infrastructure, kujenga shule. Na ungalia vile unagawa pesa kujenga shule. Mimi nilijenga shule kule Wenya Tears College. Na mjenga na CDF 100%. Lakini kuna shule ingine pa limfu na ingine huko sendo imejengwa na serikali 100%. CDF yao wanaweka kando. As MPG, I want to say this from Kisumu without any kind of contradiction, that if we don't deal with equitable distribution of resources in this country will never be the same. Because I believe that if Western grows, and Nyanza grows, and Kisi grows, and Ifali grows, and Central Kenya grows, and we grow together, we build a one prosperous country where all of us share the gains of the country. But if you only build one or two regions in the country, we all remain the poorer. Our constitution says that our resources as a country will be distributed equitably. Means that every region should get according to their needs. Tukichukua power hapa mbele, we will ensure that this country is run on the ethos of equitability. We take those of us who are weak, we work with them together and gather their hands, we work together. Those of us who are disabled, we work with them together. Those of us who have been marginalized for all these years, we must make sure that they come up. Those of us who are not able to read or write, make sure that they are able to read or write. Those of us who cannot access water, you access water. Those who cannot get education, must get education. Those of us in this country who believe that this country holds the best for them, must be given a chance to get that best in this country. Because in the last 2 years, I've seen tumajii walimu kama 1046. Edo wangalie vile wamegawa walimu. Tumajii forest officers, ena angalia wamegawa namna gani. Tumajii watu wa army, uone wamegawa namna gani. Tumeajiri watu wengi kama CEOs of parastatals, wamegawa namna gani. We cannot have a country where for you to get a job you must have a name that looks like the name of the leader. No. 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 Must have a country where all of us who have gone to school are able to get equitable, fair and just treatment. That is why we have the MDG party. Oriyothurwa, the MDG. Yimoke lakai kawono. Okengo siyasa mara Kenya kwanza. Kata Ma William. Wangi yoko mwadhi yeka Uganda. Kawono ni na muantieni. Yune na nyoro kama nyotibule nyoro. Nyoko nyoro kama nyotibule nyoro. That is why you've seen these young people here. Because they are the future of this country. They organize themselves through the TikTok, through Instagram, through Facebook, through X. The young people of this country, I salute you. The young people of this country, we love you. The young people of this country, we believe that you are doing better than you have done, those of us who have come ahead of you. We learned a lesson yesterday, and as David Ocheng, I want to assure you that I will always listen to the voices of the young people. I'll always listen to the voices of the downtrodden. That's why yesterday I said that there's no way that all of us must seek to be right. Sometimes you must listen, even if you think you are the person who is right all the time, you must listen to even the voices who think are wrong. Katabena ini mingadir machaladi, ibinya kira nafasi ya uinje ki mangata watu katakiparo watu mriyambo. Kara kokora kokoriye. Sawa sawa. I want to tell the youth of this country that the MDG party is your party. The MDG party is the party that will listen to you. The MDG party is the party that will give you a chance to run in and build your leadership possibilities. I welcome you, all the Gen Zs and the millennials. I welcome you to the MDG party. Number four, I want to talk about economic policy, and this is very important. Last year, I went and said to the president when we were facing the finance bill, and I was convinced that this country could do better with a housing levy. I was convinced we could do better by reforming our health sector system.
I was convinced that we could do well by transforming our NSSF system. And that's why last year I voted yes for the finance bill. Now, I believe that this year we should not have had another finance bill. We should have let Kenyans have some relief so that we see the gains we made in last year's finance act. Sawa. And I want to say this. That as a country, this is the time for fiscal and economic policy consolidation. It's not the time for fiscal and policy fragmentation. This is the time for fiscal predictability. This is not the time for fiscal ping pong. We want this country to be fiscally and economically stable. We don't want to play potato patter with the economic policy. We want investors to come in. We want this country, everyone, to know that next year, the other year, this is our economic policy. So I want to ask those who are advising on economic matters that we are looking for economic predictability, not economic ping pong. We're looking for economic consolidation, not economic fragmentation. We want our people to feel the economic policy that we are putting in place, holding water in their lives. And that's why, even next week, I'll still vote no for the finance bill. Because we don't want it. Kenyans don't want it. We don't want it. Kaka MDG party, Adonyi Sowu, ni kwa kao telo chiongo mbeleka. Tuwadu wani nyatimu na mwana mnyo Kenya kai. Osomu, nyaka kamogo mundo chope. Without, because Kibaki brought us free primary and free secondary education. But now we are paying school fees. It's not free. We must make free primary and free secondary education truly and truly free for every child in this country. Number two, we must ensure that our devolution system works. Today, Uganda Parashia Hospital, hakuna dawa. Hospitali, daktari ni wachache. We cannot get what we want there. For us to get proper hygiene, we have to run back down to a place called Moi Referral Hospital. We want to fix our health. We must fix our agriculture. We must fix our health system, agriculture system, education system, water system, so this country is able to grow and carry everyone else along. Koro adwa watch mar MDG. Ningependa sasa wale wanatuchukua sauti akina Rashidi. I want to speak in a language that is vernacular now. And I wouldn't want you to listen to this. So ningependa.
Mwakilishi wa people living na Kisumu County Executive. Aya, sawa. Bali kuna tashwishi mtarekebisha. Mtarekebisha tuhi hili. Chairman Mr. Onyango. Deputy Chair Fred Opala. Deputy Wake Fred Opala. Fred Opala.
Treasurer Naomi Omondi. There she is.
Yes. Halafu. People living with.
Munatuletea hapa. Na la mwisho. Tafadhali. Munapoandika. Andika jina
Najia kwamba, of course, atuwezi, tunajua mmekuwa mkiongeleshana, mkijadiliana na kadhalika. Na leo mtakopia nyinyi na viongozi wenu, mtukonfamie at county level. Kwa hivyo tupate list ya sub-county level. Manake hiyo itaenda kwa record ya chama, alafu chama na...
There she is. Secretary, Treasurer na mwenyekiti wa Women's League.
Yeah.